Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we will discuss about Unicode characters and UTF-8 encoding system. In our previous class, we discussed about string data type. This is a continuation class, so please follow our playlist from the beginning so that you will have a better understanding of the complete Python language. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, in our last class, we discussed about a string is a sequence of Unicode characters. So what's Unicode characters? Before going into the concept of Unicode characters, first we have to understand what's ASCII characters are. If you're aware of different languages, C, C++ and Java, they use ASCII characters, but Python uses Unicode characters. So first we will understand what's ASCII characters are. ASCII means American Standard for Code Information Interchange. So we discussed that strings is a sequence of characters. Empty space is a character, A is a character, new line is a character. Like that, what they have done here is they have chosen some 128 different characters and they followed a standard. So the different 128 characters are available in the internet. You can check in the internet what are the ASCII characters, and they have followed a standard. What's that mean is the 0th character is null value, the first character is the start of heading value. Like that, for each and every character they have assigned a number. So what's the use of that number? We'll understand in a bit. So let's check the examples. In the 65th character here in the ASCII table is a capital A, and 66th is chosen as capital B. So why we have to assign that standard? See, if you want to exchange some information, textual information, if everyone follows the same standards, it's easy to exchange the information because computers don't understand characters. So we save our characters in binary format. If you want to save a character capital A in computer, we will save it as binary form of 65. So what's binary format, how to convert decimal to binary format, what is hexadecimal format, all these concepts were clearly discussed in our digital logic design playlist, number system concepts. Number system concepts are very, very important for a computer science student. If you are not aware of this concept, please watch our digital logic design number system concepts and come back here. So these are the list of ASCII characters. The last one is here it is given as 127 value. So it started from 0, that's why total 128 characters. So 127th value here is a delete character. So these are the list of characters. So later on they extended ASCII characters, means they added some Latin, Greek symbols, and they made a total of 256 different characters. You can see in the internet about the extended ASCII table also. It started from 128 up to 127, the first basic 128 characters. From 128 onwards, euro symbol, these are the list of extended ASCII characters. In order to save this total 256 characters, we need 8 bits of data. That's why in one character we'll take 8 bits, means 1 byte of memory space. So here when you take a look at this ASCII table, here this ASCII table is taking only alphabets, means English alphabets, capital A to capital Z, small a to small z, numbers 0, 1, 2, 3 up to, and some quotation marks, some Latin and Greek symbols. So what about the remaining characters? Japanese, Chinese, Hindi, Armenia. So all these languages, Unicode characters take all the characters into consideration. So all the characters that present in our entire world, they are considering those into consideration. As of Unicode 11.0 standard, there are 1.137,000 around something characters are there. The same way we have done in ASCII, we have assigned some numbers. So this character means 128, this character means 127, capital A means 65, like that. The characters which has chosen in Unicode characters also, the entire world symbols, we have to assign some format. That we call it as encoding system. Different encoding systems are available. Out of those, UTF-8, UTF means Unicode Character Sticks Transformation format. So UTF-8, UTF-16, UTF-32 encoding systems are there. Python by default use UTF-8 encoding system. In this class, we will discuss about what is meant by UTF-8 encoding system and what are the all the symbols. We will check the table. So let's check what UTF-8 encoding system is. In the UTF-8 encoding system, see, in our previous ASCII table characteristics, we considered that first 128 ASCII characters, the same 128 ASCII characters in the Unicode also, the first 128 characters are the same as ASCII characters. These ASCII characters will take, in UTF-8 encoding system, these ASCII characters will take 1 byte of memory space. So the next consideration is the Latin, Greek, here Hebrew, Arabic, Tana, and all those symbols, the symbols present in these languages, they are giving 2 bytes of memory space. Okay, the remaining languages, Japanese, Chinese, Korean languages, we are taking 3 bytes of memory space, and the remaining symbols present in different other languages, all those are saved in 4 bytes of memory space. So what we have understand here, UTF-8 is using different memory spaces for different characters. For ASCII characters, it will take only 1 byte. For Latin and Greek symbols, it will take 2 bytes of memory space. For the Chinese and Japanese, it will take 3 bytes of data. And for remaining symbols, it will take 4 bytes of data. Then a string is a sequence of characters. Let's say, suppose we are taking it as a first one is capital A and the second symbol is some Latin symbol. So how we differentiate that this first character is having only 1 byte of information, second character is having 2 bytes of information? That's the point we have to understand. It is very, very important, because see here, if the first bit in 1 byte, we are having the first bit, the most significant bit we call it as, if it is 0, means the character present only 1 byte of one byte occupied, the character is taking only 1 byte. For the characters that are Latin, Greek characters, it is taking 2 bytes of information. So 110, the second, first, second and third bit should be 110. If the first, second and third bits are 110, for all the Latin and Greek symbols which are coming under this category, the first 3 bits are same, 110, it won't change. Based on that, it will identify whether it is the character is saving in 2 bytes or it is saving in 1 byte. It is taking 3 bytes of memory space, it is taking 4 bytes of memory space. Based on the first most significant bits, it will identify. So if our characters are taking 3 bytes of memory space, the first 4 bits are 1110. If it is taking 4 bytes of information, it is taking 1111410. Remaining bits may change for character to character, but these 4 bits, 5 bits will not be changed in unique UTF-8 encoding system. This is all about UTF encoding system. Now let's take a look at that UTF encoding symbols. So here, coming here, we are not showing here all the symbols. You can type in the Google UTF-8 characteristic table. See the YN symbol. N symbol means it's a Japanese denomination symbol. N. It is taking a UTF-8 encoding system of C2A5. C2A5 means it's a hexadecimal format. So it's not easy to understand binary formats. That's why they are giving it in a C2A5, means we have to convert that into binary number system. This is given as a hexadecimal format. So these are the list of symbols present in UTF Unicode characters and UTF encoding values. So let's check this in our Python language. Let's take an example. This N symbol is considered here. S is equal to N dot encoding. Encode is a method. In our last class, when we discussed only few methods. Some of the methods are not discussed because there are so many methods, it's not possible to explain all the methods in a single class. So that's why whenever it's required, encode is a method which converts our character into the format which we required. Here we are taking encoding schema as UTF-8 and we are converting into hexadecimal format. So the output here we got a C2A5, which is exactly given in the internet, the UTF-8 encoding characteristic table. Next, the example here is capital A should be given 65. 65, when you binary value of 65, when you convert it into hexadecimal format, we will get 41. That is what the output we got here. So this is all about UTF-8 encoding system. Python default uses UTF-8 encoding system. Okay, hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.